There are all kinds of discrimination nowadays, and they are increasing. Popular discrimination such as gender, nationality, and of course, health. But I have a question. Have you ever heard about age discrimination?
No.
I cannot say that it's a global problem, but it really exists and it's being global. It really exists and it's being global to you that actually, what is the age discrimination? Age discrimination is a practice of treating someone unfairly based on their age. Actually, I'm the youngest in my family, and being the youngest has a lot of advantages. You don't have to get out in the cold to throw out the trash. Your parents will pay more attention to you, and you'll have a partner who can help with your maths, English, history, and even with your personal problems. As to me, being young isn't so good. As to me, no, I haven't finished. Yes, of course. Being the youngest isn't so good. You feel distrust on yourself. Your parents, brother, sister, and people who is close to you don't trust you. And that's a very pity thing. I think that majority of us here are adults. And would you believe me if I said that we are smarter than you? Of course not. I mean that if you compare our childhood with yours, there's huge difference. For example, I'm about 16 and I can speak English. And adults here, raise your hands if you are able to speak here, to speak English at the age of 16. See? No, adults, I mean adults.
Adults?
Yes. See? And every single teenager here has their smartphone and the computer at home. And they know how to use it better than you. I don't want to boast myself and all my peers. I just want to persuade you to this. And I believe that the next generation after us will be more smarter than us and twice than you. For example, every of us has a little baby at home in their family. And have you ever noticed them how they use a smartphone? How they use a smartphone? And they can easily make a call by their own and take a photo, and they love playing games. Besides, recently, one of my three-year-old nephew broke my own record in the Subway Surfers. I was surprised. I was surprised by that. And additionally, I want to add that little babies nowadays, firstly, learn how to use it and then begin to speak. And that's a fact. And when you want to take it, they begin crying. That's what annoys me every time. Yes. You know that the childhood is one of the unforgettable moments in your life. It's beautiful. By that, this pour of dreams. And one of my biggest dreams was to become the first trillionaire in the world. Everybody said that it's impossible. You can't. You are incapable. But I'm a positive boy, and I believe that nothing is impossible in this world. Afterwards, I decided to invest my money in Bitcoin in order to come through my dream. Firstly, I had to open my e-wallet. I did so, and the next thing was to charge it with some money. However, I didn't have my Visa card, However, I didn't have my visa card. However, it doesn't accept real cash money. I had to pay by visa card. Unfortunately, I hadn't got my visa card because of my age. So I came up to my father and said, explained, mentioned all the pros and cons of the Bitcoin. And finally he said that it's impossible. It's better to get rid of this kind of unreal imaginations. The same thing was with my mother, but with quite different final. And then she imploded, she suddenly imploded and said that she believed in all my dreams. That was some kind of inspirational feeling to me. Okay, go on. As you can see from this picture, this is George Nissen. He invented the trampoline at the age of 16. Although I hadn't got a trampoline at home, but I had a sofa which I liked to jump when there was no bed at home in my childhood. And the next person is Frank Epperson. He created the first popsicles at the age of 11. I think that everybody here has ever eaten this. Personally, I adored eating this. Though I had a sore throat because it was nice and the cheapest one among all other ice creams. The next person is Richard Rohr. He's from Kenya. He invented the limelight which helped the livestock be safe from predators. Now his invention has been using all over the African continent. When you want to turn your dream into reality, want it as strong as you want to breathe it. It doesn't matter how old are you, where did you come from, and what are you going to struggle with. Once you adults here was a child and a teenager as we, and you had dreams, shared them, and one day you got negative opinions from others. As a result, you gave up and began supporting others' opinions. Finally, maybe you became a doctor, although you are extremely afraid of blood. Or a teacher, though you hate teaching. If you don't want our childhood be the same as yours, don't let our dreams be killed. Don't let our hopes be destroyed. Please, support us, support our dreams, support our opinions, so that we could support the next generation. Thank you very much.